It may be too little, too late. Last October, we told you about a Toronto police investigation based on complaints made by members of Canada's Roma community against broadcaster Ezra Levant. The complaints were in relation to on-air comments made by Mr. Levant on his Sun News Network show, The Source, in September of last year. The segment in question was titled The Jew versus the Gypsies. Now, 6 months later, Mr. Levant says he's sorry for those remarks. Here's part of the on-air apology issued this week by Ezra Levant.
Last summer, I talked about a grave problem in Ontario, a 400-person crime ring, all recent immigrants from Romania, busted by Durham Regional Police. I let it rip against crime and immigration fraud, poking fun at the gypsies who had been arrested, and even poking fun at myself as a Jew. There were some criticisms afterwards, but I dismissed them as coming from the usual soft-on-crime liberals and grievance groups. But when I look at some of the words I used last summer, like, the gypsies have gypped us, I gotta admit that I did more than just attack a crime or immigration fraud problem. I attacked a particular group, and I painted them all with the same brush. And to those I hurt, I'm sorry. I made the moral mistake of judging people collectively. There's nothing wrong with going after a criminal gang, but it's wrong to brand an entire community with a broad brush. I remain concerned about immigration fraud and crime gangs, but I can be better in the way I express those concerns. I regret having made these statements, and I'm hopeful that those remarks will serve as an example of what not to do when commenting on social issues.
That's Ezra Levant apologizing this week on the Sun News Network for poking fun. Gina Csanyi-Robah is one of those who had been calling for the police investigation. She's the executive director of the Roma Community Centre of Toronto. We reached her in Toronto.
Ms. Csanyi-Robah, what do you make of this apology from Ezra Levant?
Well, I'm certainly appreciative that he finally came to the realization that an apology was due, and the fact that he's realizing how wrong it is to use hateful and racist remarks towards our community and any community in Canada. It's definitely a step in the right direction, but unfortunately I feel that this apology is insincere, and certainly in the broader picture it's in relation to a complaint that I've made about hate propaganda from Ezra Levant. So I think there's a very sensitive time issue here that led to him making the apology at the time that he had made it.
Okay, can you just tell us a bit more about that? What do you think it is that influenced his decision to make this apology?
Well, I think that his apology was certainly influenced by the fact that the hate propaganda complaint that I made has been recommended by the Toronto Police Service to the Crown Attorney, who has recommended it to the Attorney General's office. So he may have thought that it was going to make it nowhere, that nobody would be paying attention, or that the community was just too weak and vulnerable to actually have a strong enough voice for anyone to pay attention. But the Attorney General's office is now paying attention. It's important to note that from a meeting that took place recently, his apology came 2 days directly after that meeting. And very coincidentally, a lot of what was contained in his apology, I think, was reflective of what was discussed in that meeting.
Can you tell me what was the nature of this meeting that you had with the Attorney General of Ontario that you think may have influenced somehow his decision to make the apology?
Well, when we were discussing how things were going to proceed, one of the very serious concerns that I had was the fact that I had never received an apology, that the Roma community in Canada had never received an apology. I mean, when you hear him say things like, the gypsies gypped us, I mean, that is probably the lightest thing that he said out of his entire 9 minutes of hate propaganda. And he said things that I had to bring to the attention of the Attorney General's office that were incredibly painful and hurtful. I mean, he said, in quotes, gypsies aren't a race. They aren't a religion. They aren't a linguistic group. A shiftless group of hobos, they rob people blind. I mean, this was part of what he said. I mean, he went way beyond just racist remarks. I mean, he went straight to hate and denied us even being a group of people. And he's never apologized for that in the 6 months. Even though Sun Media apologized and we were grateful for that apology, nothing came from Ezra Levant up until just a few days ago.
The network apologized for
this
9-minute rant, and as you point out, called Roma, it called them gypsies, their chief economy is theft and begging. That's the nature of that. The network apologized, but Ezra Levant never did until the other day.
That's right. And so the second part of the conversation that we had at the Attorney General's office was that we were really concerned that if he wasn't held accountable, what would he do next? So what kind of mechanism, what kind of protection would we have? So the lack of apology and fear of what would take place if he wasn't held accountable were a big part of the discussion.
If the reason why Ezra Levant had decided to make this apology is because this possibility of charges, how would he know about that? Was he part of the investigation? Do you know if the police were in telling him that there was a possibility that he would be charged?
I can't speculate on that. I know that the police were very supportive of our charge and that they had worked on it diligently for many months, and it was already out of their hands, but it had already been referred to the Attorney General's office by the Crown Attorney. So and if it was the police, he could have spoke to him over the last few months. This investigation has been going on since October.
The Attorney General initially, of Ontario, initially rejected the recommendation of the police and the regional Crown Attorney to pursue the case against Ezra Levant. Why do you believe that the case may still be active?
Because they told me that they were going to reflect on everything that we spoke about that day in their office this past Thursday, that they felt that it was important that they reflect again on the decision that they were making and that they needed more time to think about it, that they were reflecting on what was discussed that day and they were taking the matter very seriously. And, you know, when I told them about what kind of impact it's had on the community already, his terrible, hateful things that he had said, that we've been receiving hate email, we've been receiving hate phone calls at the Roma Community Centre, more of our youth have apparently been verbally and physically assaulted in school, their parents have called the Roma Community Centre complaining about these things, so it's had a real impact already. It's not like these words were way out there and they don't manifest themselves in the day-to-day lives of people. They impacted our entire Canadian Roma community. I mean, these comments, he was directing them at the newcomer portion of our community, but you know, there's many thousands of Roma throughout Canada.
You wrote that the Attorney General had suggested that it would be a very challenging case to prosecute and that it could likely turn into, quote, a bit of a circus. Do you think there is reluctance on the part of the Attorney General's office to pursue this case?
Yes, I do. I think that they feel somewhat fearful of what this could look like as it played out in the media and whether or not it would be worth that. My response was that you don't not face a challenge because you think it's too difficult or for fear that, you know, you can't control the circumstances. I mean, we have to do the right thing here, and the right thing is to hold someone accountable for what they've said and the hurt that they brought to a community in Canada. It's a message that we send to all Canadians that, you know, the law is here to protect you and to uphold you. So now when it comes to us actually doing something about it at a larger level and calling the police in to help us, and now the Attorney General's office seems to be reluctant to move forward perhaps prior to our last meeting on Thursday, I think it says a lot about the fact that all Canadians need to work a lot harder and speak a lot louder about how important we need to have the human rights provisions protecting people against hate speech back into our federal laws. And us as Canadians need to do more in standing up for more vulnerable and marginalized communities among us.
All right. We will be watching closely. Ms. Csanyi-Robah, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Gina Csanyi-Robah is the Executive Director of the Roma Community Centre of Toronto, and we reached her in Toronto.